The Junior Chamber International Eco Branch Lagos has organized a discussion forum on curbing election violence in Nigeria. This is in a build-up toward the general elections scheduled to hold next month. Young Nigerians, including students, civil society organizations, and NGOs attended the forum. Various speakers, including academia, motivational speakers, and traditional rulers, spoke on the essence of peaceful and credible elections devoid of violence.
Is it possible for us to achieve peaceful elections? Yes. If all the sectors play their roles, if the political parties do what they are supposed to do, if young people do what they are supposed to do, for example, on social media, what young people do these days is when they see an information, they retweet without verifying the source of that information.
We have so many parties, about 7 parties in Nigeria. Everybody wants to be in that position of House of Assembly, Councilor, Chairman. It's not for everyone, it's not going to be for everybody, it's just for one person alone. Just for one person, but everybody, 97 of us, want to be on our seats. Tell me why it will not lead to violence. It will lead to violence. Diabolically, autism, coming to the house to attack, you will not be sleeping alone, and even the private sector. Even those of us that are in the system, most of us don't even keep our kids and marriage at home because of the violence, because we don't know ourselves, because we don't trust ourselves, because we don't believe in God.
Peaceful election, yes I go. Violent free election, yes I go. We can have it, not immediately now, not in the next coming election, it's not possible. Nothing is a place to checkmate violence. Nothing is in place.
Only and unless politicians are discouraged from fighting for office because of this money. How do we go about that? You are going to go to this office as a part-time business. You have to have a job and you must be there. You must be gainfully employed. So whether you lose, you win, it doesn't really matter.
I think the first thing that the electoral empire, the INEC, the LASEC of this world, they need to be more neutral and independent in their approach. Two, there is need for serious political enlightenment and full-time education. And that's why I should credit JCI today for what they are doing directly, one way or another, somebody will be there and become more politically enlightened.
So if people are not well taken care of, and we are talking about free, fair election, it's a lie. It's not within the scope. It's not now. It can't come now. Nothing is put to checkmate that. Very well.